Hey everybody, my name is Yan. I want to welcome you to another episode of Devolutions HQ. In today's episode, we're going to be taking a look at some video chat or video conferencing solutions. I'm going to be calling Jenny over the line and you're going to be seeing everything that we do. So it's going to be very intuitive. But there's a lot of solutions out there right now. And a lot of you have had to make calls from home, whether you're calling a potential client or a customer, or maybe just want to video chat a coworker, or maybe you just want to call mom. And that's always a good thing. Well, there's a lot of solutions out there, and sometimes it can be a little confusing about what features and what are the requirements. So we wanted to kind of give you some of our pros and cons and kind of give a little bit of our opinion.
Now, obviously, as a security disclaimer, we don't want to condone unsecure practices. So you want to make sure that if you're exposing yourself on the internet using video, that you take the proper precautions.
So anyway, I'm going to go ahead and call Jenny right now, and we're going to take a look at how these solutions stack up. There we go. So, hey, Jenny, how's it going?
Hi, guys. Going great. And you?
Fantastic. Fantastic. So, this is Zoom, and I'll be looking over to the right. So, if you're wondering why I'm looking that way, it's because I'm looking at Jenny right now. It's my screen. That's what happens when you have multiple displays, right? Zoom is very popular. Okay. Let's say it has gotten
one of the most popular one right now, I think.
Yeah. It's got a lot of notoriety. Both for good and bad. And we'll talk about both because we want to be fair. Yeah. Right off the bat, one thing you can see on my screen here is there's a lot of features, okay, with Zoom. So the way I called her was obviously I have a Zoom account and I went ahead and sent a link to her, to her email, and then she go ahead and opened it up, which gave her permission to access my Zoom meeting. And then you didn't...
Like on my side, all I had to do was click on your link. And of course, I had to download the application.
Okay, yeah, yeah.
But that's all I had to do.
I think they're trying to add some security measures, obviously. But I had to hit admit for her to be able to join the meeting. Now, apparently, there's a lot of settings that you can actually manually set. So you could auto-invite or auto-turn-off cameras, auto-mute, auto... all sorts of stuff. For ours, at least, I enabled cameras and... I had to unmute her and then also I had to admit her. So if it was some random person you don't know, obviously you wouldn't want somebody joining our meeting right now.
And I actually also had to accept that you unmute me. Send you a little message. I don't know if you just see it. You see it just trying to chat right now. And I can send you a little thumbs up, which I don't know where it goes. Oh, I can see it on my screen.
If I give you a little clap. Bloop.
Yeah, I see the clap.
I see the clap. Very cool.
Okay.
That's really neat. There's also some options here in the window. Obviously, you can stop the video. You can edit profile picture. You can mute stuff.
You can actually record the video.
Yeah,
also.
I see a record button down here. Yeah. Yep. So you can send reactions. And there's always a little chat window. So she said, hi, Anne. And yeah. I could say, hey. And I guess you could send it to individual people as well.
I think you can. And what I like also is that I can see who's online right now and if they have their mic open and their camera open.
And it also has a security. So I guess I can lock the meeting. I've got an option to lock the meeting so nobody can enter it in. And I guess they call it a waiting room when people get in there and they're not accessing yet. And then I can select allow participants to share screen, chat, or rename themselves. I could see how this is very popular. So do you want to tell us a little bit about some of the features and pros and cons maybe?
Yeah, well, the pros, of course, it's, you know, it's clear. It's 100%. Like, it's not even close to the other one. Super easy to use. You send me the link. I click. That's it. No account needed, which is always a plus. The feature, as we can see, are pretty cool. All need feature.
Yeah.
I can see that I can actually also share my screen with you, which is cool. So it goes both ways. Otherwise, available platforms. So Zoom is available pretty much everywhere. You know, Windows 10, Mac, Linux, Web, iOS, Android, Chrome browser, Firefox browser. There's even an Outlook plugin.
I can see how you could have 10, 15. How many people total? Yeah.
100.
100, wow.
There's no requirement, no subscription needed. The downfall of all of that, I think everybody's been talking about it, everybody's been hearing about it, security-wise.
Yeah.
Like, it's a huge issue with security. Zoom actually came out with a new version yesterday, 5.0, they're trying to fix some of the bug. But I mean, you know, just to tell you one of the bug they have right now is that they can, a bug was discovered that could enable hackers to take over a Zoom user's Mac, including tapping into the webcam and hacking the microphone. And this is just one of the security features that they have issue with. The other thing that I don't like about their security is that they say on their website that they are end-to-end encryption. They are not.
Okay, wow.
So they really need to up their game with their security. I mean, I know they got hit by a wave when everybody started jumping on there to use it. They need to step it up.
So obviously, you have to do your research. And if you think it's worthy for, you deem it okay for these security issues to that don't affect you, then go for it.
Yeah, if you want to use it with friends and chat with family, don't divulge any personal information. I mean, you're good to go.
But there's a time limit, right?
There is a 40-minute time limit. That's okay. Also the downfall. After 40 minutes, it will automatically disconnect you and your meeting, and then you have to start a new one.
Okay, definitely very cool, but with the caveat that that she said the security is something you really want to make sure that you're aware of at least, okay? And go ahead and do a video call. See what happens over here. I love that intro music, by the way. It's always epic intro music. So
I have to admit, this is the best intro music that you have. Like, the ringing tone is awesome.
It really was. I was actually jamming to it with a little bit. Okay. Dance for me, dance for me, dance for me. Oh. I never seen any. Back to business. So this is Skype, probably one of the most popular, if not one of the one who start the gold standard, right? I remember back in the
exactly.
day, people were like, do you want to Skype me? People were like, what's a Skype, you know? So Skype obviously is owned by Microsoft. So you need a Microsoft account, right?
Yep.
But I think there's an advantage of that as well, as I know people that have an Xbox and you have the little webcam there, that it opens up another feature. So maybe young kids can talk to grandma, you know, using Skype. So that's a bonus feature. I've used personally a lot for when I do podcasts and things over the web. I use it a lot because the quality is very good and it seems to run really well. There's some cool little features, so I can send little emojis here. So let's send a little laughing face to her. Bloop. And then it goes on the screen.
Very cool.
There's some cool things. So you can send them. Oh, I got a thumbs up.
There you go.
Nice, nice. You can also share the screen as usual. So you can have options to share the screen. Chats. We got a little chat. Very similar to Zoom. So, hey, Jen.
Oh, chat and her. I'm saying hello, Jan. Okay. So there you go.
Perfect. Okay. And it shows up nicely. So it seems like it's got some cool features. That's oh, cool. Something I saw in the setup. Hold on. One second.
What are you doing?
You can blur your background.
Oh, I can see. Okay, that is pretty neat. Okay. I have to admit.
And okay, get ready. Boom. Look at this. I'm on the beach now. It's pretty good.
I need that one.
Maybe, oh, let's do a different beach. Okay.
Oh, okay. That's a nice beach. Very nice.
But I think they did a pretty good job. Normally, you need a green screen to do something like this. But here, they seem to incorporate some sort of technology that can fade out the user from the background. So could be kind of cool.
Yeah, that's
but
pretty cool.
The blur is nice, I guess. You know, if you have a distracting background.
Something that is neat on my screen is that I just opened like another window, like a Word document, and your face just popped up like on the top corner.
Oh, cool. So
that's pretty cool.
Yeah. So you can actually work. Oh yeah. I see that too. Yeah. So now I got your little face here so I can actually see you on my screen instead of looking to the other one. That's pretty actually deep. Nice. We didn't mention it, but I think you can send files too, right?
Yes. Yeah. You can send files, pictures, whatever you want.
Good.
I mean, take pretty a snapshot. Quick and easy.
Okay, cool. So we can take a snapshot, but.
thank you for my face, but yeah.
One of the challenges is recording conversations sometimes, especially if you're doing a podcast and you always need different software solutions and hardware applications and all kind of stuff. Well, this one, you can just hit record. And if there's two people, it'll just put it side by side automatically. And like kind of like this on my screen, you could see I can do a side by side. And it records pretty well. It's not going to be HD, you know, 4K or anything.
Quality,
but
yeah.
Overall, it's pretty good.
Oh, you see, so there are some little issues with it. We didn't have that problem with Zoom. Right now, we just froze.
Okay, it just froze, Now, obviously, things are dependent on internet connections, but okay, so that was no problem, the technical difficulties. So this is, how many users can use a Skype call?
50 video users.
Okay, wow, 50. So that's amazing.
So that's not bad at all.
No.
You do have a time limit, but I mean, it's 4-hour time limit.
Okay, that's all.
And per month, it's actually 100 hours per month.
Okay, wow. Okay. Oh, okay. Other than that?
Well, we got some of the cool feature that Skype offer. You have Skype's voice over IP.
Okay.
So you can ask Skype to give you a number. It will give you like a regular phone number. And then people can actually call from their landline, from their mobile phone, your Skype line number.
That's cool.
So, which is fun. And the Skype number is way cheaper than if you would go with, you know, a phone company. It's like $2.99 per month for unlimited minutes to call landlines and mobile.
That's really
cool. So that's
cool.
A cool feature. Yeah. There's also Translate.
Okay, yeah,
so
heard about
we
that.
Could, yeah, so it's like live translations. So I could talk to you like in English. I wanted to translate in French. It would take like a minute, and then we'll say it in French. There's just one more that I think is really cool.
Yeah.
Is the Skype Wi-Fi.
Okay.
So they actually offer Wi-Fi. So let's say you're at the airport and you need to have Wi-Fi. You don't have any service. You need it right now. Instead of paying like $25 for a day of like, you know, being in the States or another country to use Wi-Fi, you can actually like just use Skype Wi-Fi and it's $150.
Wow.
$1.50.
Okay.
So
that's amazing.
That's pretty cool. But like you said, I think maybe Skype is just, you know, doing too much.
Okay.
They should just concentrate on what they do good, video conference.
Sure.
That's my opinion,
exactly.
But they're still really awesome.
Yeah. Here, so here she is. Whoop. There you go.
Hi, guys.
Hi, Jen. So this is Google Hangouts, but maybe a little bit less known, per se. They recently said, it was last year, they said that they were actually going to be deprecating it, right?
Yeah, in 2019, but then they switched the date, I guess, with everything going on,
sure,
to June 2020.
If people were dependent on it, realize that it may not be there anymore at one point. So that's why maybe some of the features haven't been enhanced or anything like that. Now, Google Hangouts, obviously, you need a Gmail account or an account that has a Google account, okay?
Exactly.
And to be honest, it was a little bit tricky because I had to send a link and then you had to click on the link, right?
Yeah, it was a bit, we had a bit of difficulty like trying to add someone, which is going to find the contact. But with the link, it's quite easy. You send me the link, open the link, and then I have to accept your call.
Okay, perfect. So it wasn't too bad. Some of the features that Google has, I mean, it's pretty simple interface, to be honest. I know there's a little chat thing. You can say, you can write a little message and it pops up on the screen.
There's less feature than the other two.
Yeah, definitely. It's very lightweight. You can share your screen, but other than that, it's, I would say, pretty simple, let's say. But if you have three or four people just wanting to have a conversation, it does, you know, it does the screen popping where like the person talking shows up. Most of them do that. So
yeah, and what I can see, I'm just hi Ian again, sending you a message.
Okay, perfect.
I think it's gonna pop up on your screen.
Yeah.
But what I see is that if I send a message, it's to everyone in the call.
Okay. Yeah, so you
can't just send it to one person.
And it seems like I don't really have the ability I can switch the screens manually. I don't have any admin functions, you know?
Okay, yeah. Other than that, some of the downfall, I would say, would be maybe, you know, if you do it on your, the mobile app doesn't have as many feature.
Okay, wow. Okay.
The web.
Sure.
Like you can see the status of people.
Okay.
You know, which I like in the other, I can see who's there, who's not. I can't see that.
Yeah, yeah.
They did also had some little security issues.
Okay.
You know, like you can't delete your account. Once you create it, you can't delete it. And if someone added you to their contact list, you're stuck there. Like there's no way to delete yourself from someone else's contact list. They,
sure.
They will always have your information. They will be able to call you because you can't delete your account. So that's one little security flaw.
Like, I don't know, Skype's interface is a little bit cleaner and newer.
Yeah. And the image is not that crisp as it was, I find, with Zoom or with Skype.
Sure.
There's also a limit. There's 25 video users at the same time.
Okay.
And only the 10 that are talking the more that you will see appear on the screen.
That makes sense. Okay.
You won't see the 25 of them, like, you know, mosaic of people that you would see in Zoom.
Okay. Google had another application that a lot of people that have Android phones have, they just comes with their phone. So which one is that one?
That's Google Duo.
Okay.
So you won't see us try it out because it's really on your Android phone. Right now we're doing everything on the web so we can record everything.
Sure.
So Google Duo, 12 video user at the same time.
Okay.
Comes default on all Android phones. Okay. It's fast and reliable. You can record message, which is
pretty cool. Yeah.
So, you know, if you want to try to call someone and if you wouldn't have answered, I could have just recorded you a message that you would have then got.
Nice.
Pretty cool.
Yeah.
One of the features I was talking to you about earlier, it's a cool feature that only Google Duo has. It's Smile Knock Knock.
Okay.
So what it does is it will say Smile Knock Knock is on, warning you that the person you're calling will see you appear on their screen and they can then accept the call. So you can, you know, the person can decide, oh, I don't feel like talking to that person today, or, ooh, need some makeup.
Sure.
I don't know.
Yeah, I know. I didn't do
it. So you can decide, like, to answer the call or not. You can see the person before.
That's interesting. So definitely, that's cool. If we had to make comparisons, Google Duo would be kind of like the FaceTime for Android, right?
Exactly.
FaceTime is probably one of the most popular because of the ease of use. And I think it's like Google Duo as well. Duo is already on your Android phone. So if you already have an Android phone, you already have the application, you just call people. But once again, the only issue is FaceTime can only FaceTime people with FaceTime or Apple devices. But I guess if you wanted to be similar, they're similar in function, right?
They are. I mean, they have some other option. Like if you are an Apple user, you can actually use FaceTime on your Apple Watch.
That's cool as well. Yeah.
So that's pretty cool. You got FaceTime audio, so you can just decide to call instead of really see the person.
Yeah.
And you can take a live picture, you know, like we did a bit earlier. So you can send live photos to the person you're talking to.
If you have an iPhone, I mean, to me, that's my go-to. If I want to call my mom or call my sisters and stuff, it's automatically FaceTime. We just, hey, can we FaceTime each other? So there are some goods, positive, but there's definitely some cons if you're trying to call somebody that doesn't have an Apple device. All right. So now we're on Facebook Messenger. So
yes,
I think everything is good here. Let's take a look a little bit at the interface. So obviously, since it's Facebook, it's definitely very intuitive because the idea is there's a button right there. You just hit the button and you can call them instantly.
You have to be friends with them.
But you have
Me
to be friends
Dad
with them.
Me and Dad were trying earlier and we kind of realized for the first time that we weren't Facebook friends,
we couldn't call each other.
So.
So if you have friends on Facebook, it is a simple feature. I'm not really a fan of Facebook's interface. I mean, just the way it works, but it seems like it's got similar features. You know, you can share your screen. You can add group members to the groups if you want to do like a group chat. Pretty simple. Yeah, pretty simple. Almost like a Google Hangouts in a way.
Yeah.
Anything on your end? What did you see?
Quality is not top notch right now.
Okay.
Like I will admit, like I've seen better quality. I think with the Google and even we can go back to Zoom or Skype, which is better quality.
Sure.
It is the one I always use when I do like happy hours with my friends now. We social distancing, so we're doing happy hours by phone, by messages, and that's how we do it with Messenger. And I find that the issue is always quality. Sound will sometime like cut off.
Mm.
And also, what is the little downfall I found is that on your screen on your phone, you don't really see the person. Like if you're too many, like it's not super well made.
I see.
But as you said, super easy to use. Everyone who has Facebook can use it with just a click of the finger. You create your Facebook message group, just call and calls everyone at the same time.
Sure.
Other feature that is cool. Is that if you're actually talking to a group of people and one is like, oh my God, I just have to go and run somewhere and I'll be back on the call, they can hang up and they can connect to the call again.
Okay,
to
that's
everyone
really cool.
So they can rejoin the group. You know, it's easy, it's straightforward. You can have 50 video users at the same time.
But one thing I know they had was Messenger Kids. Now, we're not reviewing it here or anything. I know my kids have used that before and the parent is the one who manages all the security and stuff, but then they can just face chat their friends with that. So
I have it with my nieces.
Okay, yeah.
So, you know, right here. So I can chat with my nieces. It's my sister who created the account. And my nieces added me so we can chat together. I think it's a cool little toy.
And you know, like some kids, like my kids don't have a phone. So at least Facebook Messenger, you can put on a little like a Chromebook or a tablet or something like that. And then you can kind of constrain and know who they're talking to. Now, one thing that we thought would be cool was it's always fun to give away prizes, right? And we're going to pick a random prize winner from a comment below. And it is for what?
It is for a phone loop. Oh. So you can actually attach it to your phone and you can hold your phone.
Oh.
So while you're texting or messaging with your friends, well, you won't drop your phone and then break it.
That's a great idea. So it's, it has to do with video chatting. So that's perfect. So.
Yeah. And it's a nice little devolution one.
Excellent. Well, cool. All right. Well, I hope these different, our little overviews and reviews were helpful as you look at different solutions that are out there. Maybe you've discovered one that you've never used, but definitely take a look at them, try them out and see which ones you like best and make sure you comment below as well. All right. So yeah. Jen, thank you so much. And
thank you again for everything. It was really cool.
It was a lot of fun. And definitely we hope that you guys enjoy these types of videos. So just put your comments and any ideas you have below and make sure you like and subscribe to our videos as well. All right. Until next time. Thank you guys so much. Have a great day.
Bye guys. Stay safe.